title belt.
I'm glad to hear you say that, because Jeff Jarrett is a deserving world champion. But now, to take on three men at once, when you have what everybody wants, what this man wants, Big Papa Pump, the one big prize he hasn't had. Boy, this is a big test for Jeff Jarrett. Can he do it? Can he get to the badge at the beach as world champion? I don't know. What do you think?
Yesterday, Mike Tenay and I visited the International Wrestling Institute and Museum in Newton, Iowa. Amateur and Professional Wrestling Hall of Fame, prominently displayed. Scott Steiner, the All-American from the University of Michigan. Not there anything about Goldberg. Scott Steiner is a disciplined athlete. He's an undisciplined man on the mic. But Goldberg is strictly in it for the money.
And then Kevin Nash, obviously the fourth man. Well, fans, one man's gonna walk out the world champion here. And of course, waiting in 13 days is Hollywood Hulk Hogan, the man who won his match at the Great American Bash, who deserves the shot at Bash of the Beach and will get it. But who will the champion be in 13 days? Will it still be Jarrett? Will it be Scott Steiner? Will it be Goldberg? Or will it be Big Sexy? And where is Big Sexy as we await the entrance?
Scott Steiner and Jeff Jarrett already at the ring. We hear the music of the Wolfpack awaiting Big Sexy.
Hold on a second. I'm told by there's something going on backstage. Look, it's Goldberg over the lifeless body of Kevin Nash.
God, did you see the mount he was in? He was raining him down right into the temple of Kevin. Nash is unconscious.
He broke into Nash's dressing room and hammered him, and Nash is unconscious. And now Jeff Jarrett is taking the advantage here on Scott Steiner. He attacked him from behind.
Why can't Goldberg settle it in the ring? Why is he forever jumping someone from behind, using weapons, and running away when it looks like a fair fight?
My question is, what's Goldberg going to do when he gets to the ring? I mean, he's been in Jeff Jarrett's corner, kind of. The money's put him there, but Goldberg wants that world title, and more important, he wants to hurt anybody in his path. Right now, Jarrett's in his path.
We have not seen Goldberg arrive in the ring area. Now it's one-on-one. We don't know if Kevin Nash will be able to bounce back or not. Basically, what Goldberg has done is allow this to be a one-on-one match. If he arrives, that would kind of make it a three-way dance, so to speak, instead of a four-corner match, if Kevin Nash couldn't make it.
In Tampa, Florida, Hulk Hogan, Hollywood Hogan, watches with intensity. He is still severely injured following the jackhammer through a table a couple of weeks ago. Who will his opponent be in 13 days at Master Lock's Bash at the Beach? Right now, it's Jeff Jarrett. It could be Steiner. It could be Goldberg. And by all rights, it could be Nash.
That's right, but who does this help out? Does it help out Steiner, or does it help out Jeff Jarrett? It's one-on-one. One, two, there's Goldberg's music. Here it comes. Goldberg waited till looked like till Jarrett's shoulders were down. Jarrett gets dumped out.
Oh,
Goldberg!
Man.
Oh, my goodness. One punch, and Steiner goes down like a wedge.
He didn't have a choice. Goldberg, look at that.
This is unbelievable. That's Scott Steiner at 280 pounds. And he goes like it was nothing.
That's the kind of power move Scott Steiner usually pulls on other people, and he just had it pulled on him courtesy of the sideboard.
Like he was a cruiserweight, and he's not done. He's cooked. He's waiting. He missed.
His shoulder hit that ring post.
You may be right.
Goldberg
may
be hurt.
Now he beats up that rubble. Let's go. He's going to the wall.
No. No, Jarrett.
Oh, my God. He almost won the thing.
Hey, Jarrett was smart. He saved his own title there.
That's what you got to do. It's become a three-way dancer. Good luck, Kevin Nash. Short power bomb. Hit a save by Goldberg.
The butterfly power bomb from Scott Steiner. Jeff Jarrett once again knocked whoopee. But Goldberg has taken the measure of Scott Steiner. Have we ever seen Scott Steiner manhandled like Goldberg is doing here on Nitro?
Scott Steiner was one count away from pinning Goldberg, it seemed, and also winning the world title of the Jarrett. And now what we got here is not a three-way dance. We've got a handicap. It's a two-on-one, Scott.
Exactly. We've seen the knowing winks from Jarrett and Goldberg. They're going to double-team Scott Steiner while Kevin Nash is unconscious backstage.
I got to admit, I thought Goldberg would be out for himself. Maybe he will be. Who knows? But right now, it's Goldberg and Jarrett against Big Papa Pop.
Look, it appears that Goldberg is not trying to win the world title. It looks like he's just trying to torture Scott Steiner. Look at the cross arm breaking. And on the other end, Jeff Jarrett stomping away, pushing the referee back. I guess any friend of Kevin Nash is an enemy of Goldberg's, right?
Out of the fireman's carry slam from Goldberg into the crossarm breaker, Scott Steiner, the friend of Kevin Nash, who lies unconscious backstage, being dismantled by the Chosen One and the Cyborg, the devil himself, Goldberg.
Jarrett better get back into it, because if Steiner gives up, Goldberg's going to be the world champion. But maybe, I don't know why Jarrett did that, but he turns back on, and uh-oh. What now? Mike Awesome is not in this match.
Mike
now,
Awesome lost his qualifier to Kevin Nash.
And remember the no interference rule. Now what's going to happen here? What's going on? See, the Goldberg just choked.
He just took the United States Heavyweight Championship belt.
He's got to, is he stealing the belt? He's got to earn that thing at Bash of the Beast.
Steiner's back, over the top.
Did he ever go for goes down? Oh, Jeff Jarrett from behind. Now, one,
this could be
two,
it.
No.
Frankensteiner attempt into the short powerbomb by Scott Steiner.
How is Scott Steiner wrestling with so much fervor and power? Defeating him to power slam.
I don't know. One, two, and
Mike Awesome.
Awesome makes the save. Awesome's got the U.S. belt. Clobbers the U.S. champion with it. And now it's only Jeff Jarrett.
This is outside interference. Come on.
Well, yes, it is. But it's also the new blood. And Kevin Nash.
Kevin Nash
wobbles down finally. Scott Steiner busy with Mike Awesome.
Nash has Jarrett one-on-one right now.
Can he do it? Can he win this thing? He might do it.
There's the side slam.
He might do it. He's not done. He's got him out. Jawbreaker across the top.
Oh, snake eyes. That's a bad roll for Jeff Jarrett.
Ooh, but to the face.
The four quarters match is on.
Oh,
that's
yes.
A Nadal choke slam. Awesome's in the ring. Come on, where's the DQ?
Oh, yeah.
I don't want a DQ. I want a winner. I want a loser.
You
I
go,
want
yes.
Goldberg.
For
what a kick.
You got to let him go. They're standing everywhere.
Yes, jackknife.
Oh, no. He was going to jackknife Goldberg. He was going to jackknife the big butt.
Oh.
The big butt. Can that
no,
go?
No.
Standing sidekick, one, two, three.
No.
It's the kick that knocked Bret Hart out of WCW. And it gives Jeff Jarrett the win, the kick from Goldberg.
Goldberg did. He did not want the world title. He didn't care. He just wanted to destroy Steiner and Nash.
That's what's left of Scott Hall's contract. Do you see that? What's going to happen on Thunder on Wednesday?